This is Great Chefs of France, featuring some of the country's top artisans from Rouen to Lyon, from Paris to Cannes. Welcome to a culinary tour of some of the world's preeminent dining destinations. This time from Rouen, Michel Troglot. From Paris, Alain Sandorans. And from Vienne, Jean-Marie Aubois.
Michel Troglot's famous name obviously provided an entree for him early on. He worked variously at Freddy Girardet in Switzerland, Roger Verger and Alain Chapelle in France, and even Chez Panisse in San Francisco. From Maison Troglot in Rouen, he offers a mussel appetizer. The chef begins by prepping vegetables for a broth: carrot, green onion.
Vous voyez que je change à chaque fois de couteau parce que chaque couteau a une utilisation particulière.
Note the interesting way that the chef purees garlic. Yellow and red bell pepper, which he peels. The peppers are julienned and finely diced. Sprigs of thyme and a bay leaf are added, and the vegetables are softened in olive oil.
Deux branches de thym, une feuille de laurier. Suffisamment d'huile d'olive dans une casserole pour nous permettre de suer la garniture. Pendant ce temps, j'aurai nettoyé les moules sous l'eau courante. Et nous allons cuire les moules avec le vin blanc.
The mussels were cleaned and debearded. Then white wine is added.
Donc également sur le feu avec un couvercle.
They are covered and steamed until they open. A little more olive oil is added to the veggies.
Vous voyez, j'ai été un peu fébrile sur l'huile d'olive. Je vais rajouter un petit peu d'huile d'olive.
While the mussels cook, they should be stirred. Then more ingredients are added to the vegetables.
Ma garniture, auquel je vais ajouter
tomato paste,
le vinaigre de Xérès,
sherry vinegar.
Voilà, comme ceci. Quelques gouttes de tabasco. Et voilà. Délaye bien la tomate concentrée dans la casserole. Et on continue la cuisson.
Mmh.
débarrasser mes moules. Et je filtre le jus de la cuisson à travers un chinois sur ma garniture.
After the mussel juice is poured into the vegetables, the liquid is reduced by half.
Voilà. Dans l'assiette. Alors là, c'est un travail de patience, mais on a tout le temps puisque c'est un plat froid.
The presentation is not complicated, but time-consuming, with concentric rings of mussels on the plate. The chef says since they serve the dish cold, it's not a problem. Chopped fresh tarragon is sprinkled over the mussels. Then the vegetables in the broth are strained and also sprinkled onto the dish.
Là, terminé avec un mixeur.
Olive oil is added to the broth, then it's processed with a hand blender.
Vous voyez que la cuisine est une foule de petits détails comme ça. Faut être très généreux hein, sur l'âme.
He says it should be eaten cold, especially in the summer with its spicy flavor. But you can eat it warm too. He just prefers it cold.
Beaucoup d'aromates, mais on peut aussi le manger chaud, mais pour ma part, je préfère froid. The chef de cuisine at the venerable Lucas Carton in Paris is Alain Sonderon. In the late 50s, he apprenticed at the Ambassador Hotel in Lourdes, then entered military service. His career since then has been in Paris, where in 1985 he came to Lucas Carton. His entree is called roasted lobster vanilla. As the chef begins, we will once again tap the translation of Marc Cosnard de Closet.
Qui est une grande recette de Lucas Carton qui se sert avec des grands chardonnays blancs de la Bourgogne.
This is a famous Saint-Laurent recipe served with Burgundy Chardonnay wines. Here we have, we're going to poach it in a carrot, leek and onion courbouillon. We use this to poach the lobster.
Nous allons faire un beurre blanc.
We're going to make a beurre blanc. He's saying we're missing the vanilla.
Ah,
we're going to make a beurre blanc.
classique, mais dans lequel classic il y a de la vanille.
However, we put vanilla in it.
Est, les chardonnays, les morceaux, par exemple, les prunimons hachés.
I put vanilla in this because
et
it complements
avec le plat,
the wines.
Je trouve ça formidable.
Which are most Chardonnay and Burgundy white wines have a vanilla aspect to them. And that's why I put the vanilla bean into the sauce.
Nous avons acheté des échalotes.
We have chopped shallots. So here's making the beurre blanc.
Alors nous allons faire étuver les échalotes 3-4 minutes dans le but, surtout pas les colorer pour le beurre blanc.
Sweat the shallots for 3 or 4 minutes, you don't want them to colorize.
Nous les allons les mouiller au champagne. Alors vous pouvez mouiller au champagne, vous pouvez le mettre du vin blanc de préférence de Bourgogne blanc.
Here we're going to add some champagne to them. You can use preferably a white wine, and definitely a white Burgundy wine would be nice.
Pour saluer l'Amérique, nous avons mis du champagne pétillant.
So to pay tribute to America, we're using champagne.
C'est le champagne Lucas Carton, demoiselle Lucas Carton.
This is the house champagne, Lucas Carton, demoiselle. Some vinegar.
And
we let this reduce.
Et maintenant, nous allons mettre à cuire dans le court bouillon le homard.
And now we're going to put the lobster into the court bouillon and let it poach for about 5 minutes. Now we add the vanilla.
On a coupé le bâton en deux.
We cut the vanilla bean half lengthwise and we took out the seeds. I like watching wine reduce. I like the smell.
Un peu de crème.
We add some cream.
A good deal of butter is whisked until emulsified.
Some pepper to the beurre blanc.
La sauce est prête.
Now our sauce is ready. Now I'm going to remove the lobster.
Non, il est pas.
Maybe he's checking the lobster. It's not really ready yet.
Encore 2 minutes.
A couple more minutes. Now we're going to cook the baby spinach and butter.
The wilted spinach is seasoned, then drained on a towel. Meanwhile, in some butter and chopped shallots, the chef opens some cockles. Cockles are in the bivalve family with a heart-shaped shell. They have a gritty, chewy texture and mild flavor.
And then we take the shells off. We take the shells off and put the meat aside for the sauce.
An assistant has broken down the cooked lobster for presentation.
Alors, ce plat se sert avec un rince-doigt parce que il est recommandé de manger le coq.
So we suggest eating what's inside the head too. Spinach, asparagus tips.
Alors on a mis dans la cuisson de la coque. On a mis un peu de beurre et de crème.
So we put a little bit of butter and cream into the cockle cooking juice, and we're going to put the cockles back in that cream cockle juice mixture. Now we put our vanilla sauce into this saucer. And in the dining room, the maitre d' will cover the lobster and all the vegetables with the vanilla sauce.
La Pyramide in Vienne has always been historically important. The pastry chef is Jean-Marie Aubouin. He says he always liked to eat and became curious about how things were made. He certainly found that out working for Alain Ducasse in Monte Carlo and Paris. He took third in the French Dessert Championship. Here is chocolate crunchy cake. The chef starts with what he calls a praline. It will ultimately serve as the base for the dessert. It's comprised of melted milk chocolate, praline paste, and finely crushed crepes. It also contains Zadua. It's from Switzerland and is a smooth hazelnut-flavored chocolate. It's available in several styles, including milk chocolate and bittersweet chocolate. It's thinly spread on parchment and will be refrigerated. The body of the dessert is a praline mousse. It, too, uses Zadua chocolate. There is also what the chef calls a nut and praline cream, a sort of hazelnut paste that is also added. Heavy cream is heated on the range and will be poured onto the chocolate praline mixture. Essentially, the chef will be preparing a ganache.
Voilà, donc la crème boue. Nous allons verser sur le géant du jas et le praliné. Ceci va fondre le géant du jas.
After the ganache is thoroughly mixed, it will be set aside to cool. Then whipped cream will be folded in.
Donc une ganache.
Meanwhile, the chef prepares what he calls paradise frosting, cocoa powder, sugar, water, and heavy cream brought to a boil on the range.
Que je vais porter à ébullition, tout en remuant. Il faut toujours remuer parce que le cacao accroche.
After the mixture comes to a boil, chopped dark chocolate is added.
Voilà, donc c'est à ébullition. On obtient donc une sauce.
The chef says that this is a sauce they use on profiteroles, miniature cream puffs filled with the sweet mixture.
La glace vanille, logiquement. Donc nous allons additionner le chocolat. Comme ceci. Voilà. Bien mélangé pour faire fondre la couverture.
Stirring constantly, the chef says it should become a smooth, shiny consistency. Let the mixture cool.
Comme celle-ci. Voilà. Qu'on va laisser tiédir pour napper les palais.
Meanwhile, the chocolate praline base has set and is cut into discs. They go in the bottom of ring molds.
Voilà, comme ceci. Bien mis à l'intérieur. Voilà. Comme ceci.
The ganache has cooled down and whipped cream is folded in.
La ganache de crème fouettée. Il faut mélanger délicatement. Voilà, comme ceci. Donc, la mousse
he says this should be the final texture. The mixture is ladled into the ring molds.
Voilà. Et on lisse bien le dessus.
The tops are smooth and the molds go into the freezer for at least an hour. The frozen dessert is unmolded and the paradise frosting completely coats it.
Voilà, donc on verse bien dessus pour bien napper entièrement le palais.
Because the praline mousse is frozen, the chocolate frosting sets up almost immediately.
Comme ceci.
For presentation, it's cut in half.
Hop, allez, coupé. Avec la spatule, donc, au milieu de l'assiette, le palais ouvert. Voilà, comme ceci.
This is a coffee-flavored custard.
Au milieu. Comme ceci.
Caramelized hazelnuts.
Pour rappeler le praliné. Comme ceci. Voilà.
A caramel sugar design completes presentation.
Qui va nous permettre de donner de volume comme ceci, voilà, et une feuille de menthe pour apporter un petit peu de couleur, et voilà.